A collection of toy cars. Power wheels, battery-powered vehicles for kids are authentically styled ride-ons with real working features. Power wheels by Fisher-Price, built to go as far as their imaginations.
Look at this. Yes, yes, there it is. We are going to present this to the one of you four who bids, goodbye, Chantel, who bids nearest the actual retail price without going over. Don't speed. There you are. If that, is that, where's that little car that he won? Is it right there just off stage? I'd love to see if you can bring it in. I'd love to see him ride it for the first time on the show. In the meantime, he's a winner. And here goes Cornelius, soloing for the first time on The Price is Right. There it goes. He's going to Acapulco. He's going to Alaska. Long live Cornelius.
Just a moment. She said something terribly important, and I'm not sure I heard her correctly. What'd you say?
You look younger. It's not a compliment. I'm dealing with facts.
Now, just a moment. She added something there. What?
I said you look younger in person.
And then
a compliment. I have nothing to do with you. I'm giving you the facts.
The facts? These are the facts. You're a brilliant woman, Kim. You really are.
Two numbers. Write it down. Using two. $40. Where did you say this group is from? What school?
We're from different schools. It's a national student.
Which one
student
are you from?
Washington State University.
Washington State.
I'm a Cougar.
Do you do all of your math backwards like that?
I changed my mind.
All right. Now, there are three numbers in the price of the lamps. Using three of those four numbers, write down the price of the lamps. $568 is wrong. Try again. $586 is not right. You want to say $86? Now, wait a minute. Well, no price begins with zero. You want to say $86? You have to use three digits. Change it. Yeah. Please do. $580. No. $650. The price is $680. She has $650, but we're desperate. Give her the land. All right, now, you have four chances to win that car. Now, wait a minute. Where are you going with this thing? In the price of the car, there are five numbers. Now, look. Here they are. These five numbers. Write it down. The price of the car. Go. $18,420. No. All right. Try again. Go ahead. $14,820. That is not right. You still have two chances. $18,000. Go ahead. I tell you. Now, before I even look, I want to say one thing. No contestant has upset the audience more than she has. I have never had an audience so totally out of control. Now, you're going to have to watch your blood pressure out there. 18,240. No. One more chance. Come on up here, Jody, and write it down. This is it. Write it. Go, go, go. Right. Write it down. 14,000. We're not going to have time for the big wheel, you know that. 14,000, 20, you only use each number only once. No, you have two fours there. You can't use two fours. Change one of the fours. 14,821, 0. Isn't that beautiful? I hope you understand, neatness counts. 14,820. I know, but people, you've done it now. 21,840. What do we have here? This is supposed to be, you know what? I don't think I'm going to be able to finish this show.
Oh, he just made it. It's 63 cents and only one hurdle to go. Now, if he gets over this, you have won all those motorcycles. And this is the lowest hurdle I've seen in this game since we started playing it. Is he going to get over the last hurdle? Well, I don't know. He's won the race. He's won the race. So this must be left. So here it comes. Just open it up, that hurdle that you're raising there, 61 cents.
A new Cadillac. A Cadillac sedan de ville. Luxury, comfort, and V8 power with sophisticated Cadillac style. Comes equipped with standard features plus a leather seating area, Cadillac emblems and crest and gold plate, DeVille option package B, Teflon clear coat protection, and California emission.
Now, John, you heard that is a Cadillac. There was such a big reaction. You understand we're playing for a Cadillac here, right?
Yes, I do.
Yes. $34,295. Now, the question of the hour is, has our young Marine John just won a Cadillac? What is the first number, please? He has that right. What is the next number, please? Oh, you made a good change there. You made a good change there. Show us the next number. John! 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 Show us the next number. And the last number. You have it. John, you won it. You won it. The car is yours. The Cadillac belongs to you, John. Enjoy. We've been in a very serious discussion throughout that commercial. I'm out here in what I thought was a green and black tie, and Fingers Greco came out and said, "Do you know your tie's blue?" And of course that worried me because I didn't want to wear a blue tie with a black suit. I know you could, but and then Lisa says it's black. What do you think, Joe? Not her sweater, my tie. He turned around and took a look at Lisa's clothes. What do you think?
Blue.
Blue? Joe. That's right. Sit down. That's what you...
Black.
Black. How does it look to you?
Well, I think your suit looks blue.
The suit is black. I know that.
The suit looks blue.
How'd I end up with all these colorblind contestants? Too late to do anything now about it anyway. Rod, get me another player, please. Bring Rebecca the Super Bowl. Now for the sofa and the wall unit. Go, Rebecca. Oh! Now, I have never had this happen. Roger? I'm going to make a rule here with your permission. Roger, you know, Roger is sort of a... I don't know what he is, but I've discussed a lot of things with him. I think Mark Goodson Productions would be proud of me if I would say anytime the ball stays like that, you get it over. You get it over. What do you say? All right. Now the problem becomes, how do we get it out of there? Would any another ball? How about another ball? Do we have another ball? Do we have any other balls? What? Roger, help me. Don't just leave me out here. You're getting another ball. All right. They're getting another ball, and we're going to give you this over. Here. Doug Quick quickly got a ball. Bring it right over there. Give it to her. There you are. Thank you, Doug. Now, get that in the wind circle, and you still win.
And I say that the actual retail price of the mantel clock is $6.99, and the winner is Jay. Of Azusa Pacific University. Up here on our stage.
Oh, yes.
Yes, yes, yes. 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 That has not happened to me since I met that lady from Samoa. Remember her? I have not. How many years ago was that? That was about, Fingers, how many years ago did that Samoan pick me up? No, not the one out on the street, the one on the show. About 10 years ago, you remember, any of you see that show? It was on a lot of other shows too. She picked me up and threw me around, and it hadn't happened in all these years, and then I met you. But Susan here, she asked me, she said, I'd like to thank three people for working for me today. Can I do that? You mean it takes three people to replace you at work?
I work a 12-hour shift.
You work a 12-hour shift, so each of them works only 4 hours?
Well, I have one working 8, one working 4, and the other working 2. Whoops, no,
now, wait a minute. 8 and 4 are 12, and 2 are 14. Obviously, you are not a mathematician at work, are you? Well, then why? Now, let's go through this. One works 8, then one works 2, and one works 2.
One's working 8, and then the other one's working 4. And actually, they did.
Where did the third one come in? Why are you?
They're working till 9, because I usually work till 9 in the evening.
I don't care what time they're working to. If one works 8 and one works 4, that's 12 hours.
Right.
Well, then what's that third one doing?
She's actually working extra.
For you?
For me, yeah. It'll be because I normally work 12 hours. So, but
spin the wheel. I'm getting a headache. This is it, Thomas. This is it. The check game. Do you know this game?
No.
You do not know it. Then I shall explain it. I want you to decide what you believe is the price of that trip to Acapulco, at least in general. Then I want you to write this check for an amount that we will add to the price of the trip to Acapulco. And if the total is $5,000 to $6,000, we'll give you money in the amount of the check, and we'll give you the trip to Acapulco. Do you understand?
Sure.
All right. Are you sure you do? I've never had anyone understand before who didn't know how to play, but if you are the first...
How long is the trip for?
How long is the trip? For six nights?
Let me look. It is six nights. Six nights, Bob.
Six nights. You can't stay there in the daytime, but it's six nights.
Okay.
Step over there and write there. No. We're going to add the price of the trip to whatever you write the check for.
So if it's within $5,000, $6,000...
You go. You go to Acapulco. And you get the money in the amount of the check. He's checking. He's checking with someone who's been to Acapulco. Now, just a moment. He has a question. What is it?
Okay. Do I write the cost of the check and the cost and $5,000 plus the Acapulco?
Get Susan back here. I want to know why she has three people working for her, you know?
The actual retail price of that telescope is $975, and Mary and you... One time, I had a girl just about this tall. She got under my chin and did that. Jumped out. So now when they're doing that, I move aside. No, that's not. Audience, what is it? Okay. Here we are, Miriam. Write it down. $18,000. Go ahead. $13,000. Come on, Miriam. $21,000. Miriam, write it down. Here, now, Miriam, you're going to lose your turn if you don't write it. $13,000. $12,830. No. Now, Miriam, try again. $21,000. Now, go ahead. Write it out, Miriam. What? $21,380. No, Miriam. I don't know about you, but she's wearing me out. $21,830. That's it. You've won the car, Miriam. You've won the car. The van is yours, Miriam. We'll be back with the Showcase Showdown after this.
I got the van.
Very well. What is the price of the grill pan?
$25.
$25, is that right? No, and here he goes again. He's going on and on, 15 and on. Saturnina, this is getting serious. He's up 19. Yes. 21. Stop. 22. Saturnina. Saturnina. Oh. $40. Saturnina, I am sorry. I'm sorry for you, and I'm sorry for the mountain climb. We will try again after we have this message. Now, if there are any mathematicians there at home or here in the audience, follow this. If Saturnina missed the first prize by $10, the mountain climber would move up 10 steps, right?
Right.
If she missed, which she did, if she missed the second by $15, which she did, he would go on up to 25 and stop, wouldn't he?
Yes.
Therefore, she could have tried to get the third prize, and if she got it exactly right, he would have stayed right there and she would have won the game, right?
Yes.
But on the second prize, he inadvertently went over, didn't he?
Yes.
So we're doing the only fair thing. We're going to give her the prize. She is going to London. She's going to London. Saturnina. The actual retail price is $11.40, and the winner is Teresa. Hello, Teresa. You pronounce it Teresa or Teresa?
Teresa, fine.
Teresa. Teresa, I look around here and I see a completely empty stage. Do you think we're out of prizes? No!
It's a new car! A Mercury Tracer four-door notchback, a durable and substantial compact that's also fun to drive. Comes with standard features, air conditioning, AM/FM stereo cassette, Matt's alarm, and California emission. Mercury Tracer.
A Mercury Tracer for Teresa, if she has $1 left at the end of the Lucky 7 game. Now, let's give her the first number in the price of the car. One. What is the second number in the price of the automobile?
Nine.
Nine. Open that door. Oh, you're broke. Roger, keeper of the statistics, has this ever happened before? That a contestant has gone, he won't answer till they get a camera on him, that big ham. No, it has never happened before. Teresa, you're broke. You've missed it by eight. Not only are you broke, you owe me a dollar. I'm sorry. What more can I say? Open the other doors and let's just have a look at them, I suppose. You go wandering off. The game's over. It's all over. No Mercury Tracer. I'm sorry. Thank you. $17,400. Now, is the last number the zero in front of you or the five behind? And you have no more prizes, no more chances. This is it. This is for the car. What is it? Zero or five? Five. No. Now, wait a minute. That blinked. It's right. It's right. It's right. Congratulations. Oh, that sound effects almost ruined her day. And believe me, you're going to be happy to be here when you hear what Rod has to say.
Sean, now you have a chance to win up to $10,000 in cash.
$10,000, but you have to begin with just $1, Sean. Take that thing down there. And what's the target price today? It is $3. I want you to pick out products that are less than $3, and you can win money. And I wonder if he might be able to get at least one right. Right over here, Sean. $249. Move him up to $1,000. Now, you can quit right now and take the $1,000. Or you can try to pick the one remaining product that's less than $3.
I'll go for it.
Now, if you... He's going to go for it. He's going to go for it. What is less... Go and touch the product that's less than $3. Just a minute. I have to know about this. Now, I have to know. Sean, when we revealed this game, this was hanging down. Didn't you see that?
I thought it was already picked. I didn't think. I thought it was already.
You thought it was already chosen?
Yeah.
By whom? Sean, you have $10,000. That's what's important. Debbie can't bid. She's crying. She's crying. And this sweet little swimmer here from Union is, you know, patting her. Yes. Now, Debbie, everything is going to be fine. What do you bid on that prize? Actual retail price, $535. Debbie wins. Come up here, Debbie. Come up here, Debbie. Debbie, I think, is still crying just a little bit. She's all excited about having Rod invite her to come on down. Hello, now. Are you all right now?
No, sir. No, sir.
You're not all right.
Oh, God. I'm all right. I'm all right. Okay.
You're going to be all right. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get you through this.
Okay.
I have not lost a contestant in all these 27 years, and I'm not going to lose you. I'm going to get you through this. You may end up in the hospital, but I'm going to get you through this. Now, do you know that Debbie, it's not just nervousness. She is worried about something that would never have occurred to me. She's afraid that it is candid camera, that she's not really on The Price is Right. Now, this is not candid camera. All right, drop it on her. No. You're fine. You're fine. This is the real thing. Now, we're going to take care of it. Show everyone the price of the dinnerware, and audience, do not try to help us. Brian, that clock will start again with your bid on the dinnerware.
$89.
Higher.
$105.
Stop the clock. Are you saying $89? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
And then you said $100?
Yeah, I wasn't just saying higher. Yeah.
Brian, what kind of a show do you think this is? Does that... You couldn't buy those saucers for $89.
Now, I am going to inform you that $150 is low. Low, Brian. And the clock will start with your bid again.
45.
Stop the clock again. Are you saying $45?
No, $485.
You're saying what?
$485.
Look, Brian, to do this successfully, you're going to have to speak English. Now, what did you mean, $485?
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you say for it? What did you say?
$485.
$485?
Yeah.
Try again. Higher.
$550.
Higher.
$565.
Higher.
$595.
Higher.
$650.
Higher.
$800, $900.
Now, was his last bid $800 or $900? Is that what he said? Brian, for both of our sakes, I'm glad your time is up.
Now, which one do you want out of there, the four, the two, or the nine?
The two.
She wants that two out of there, and that two is stuck. Is out of... Well, I'll swear, nothing's going right today. The envelopes are not working, the twos are... Oh, I think it's going to blow up. My nine has tilted, and I insist on neatness. There. There. All right. Now, if it's $14.95, you win. The actual retail price is $14.95.
$420. That's it, but it's not dropping. There it goes. Never. Never in the history of the 10 chances game has a contestant won, won, won. I think once we had win, win, miss, win, didn't we? But never win. Rachella, let's make history. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Your name will go down with Christopher Columbus. Yes. And perhaps Pocahontas. Now using four of, because you understand this game. Just a moment. Now wait, wait. I am dealing with a scientist here. What kind of car is it, John?
Bob, it's a two-door Chevette hatchback economy car.
There you go. Are you ready? Make history. $5,800. And $60. Does she win? She won it! Oh! Oh! I know. Now wait. I know that's the wrong price. They made a mistake. But when we make a mistake, we give them the car anyway. Yes, you see the price is $6,850, and they dropped it by mistake. But now listen, it's just like Roger Maris and his home runs. There'll be an asterisk by it in the record book. But she did win.
Did I win?
No, you didn't win, Rachel. Yes, you did. Yes, you get the car. You get the car. And now I'll say this. The way she was playing the game, you can tell she knows the game, and she would have won the car. Congratulations. You bet. Bye-bye.
And the game for you is Bump. And, look at this. Ray Combs, ladies and gentlemen. Ray is going to do a new show here on CBS. Family Feud is coming back. And Ray, thank you, Bob. Would you like your escort?
Thank you. I'll tell you, these are Combs cuties.
Combs cuties.
No, we're Bosser's beauties. You're going to have to go find your own cutie.
Thank you, Diane.
All right. Now, think it over for a moment and tell me, What is the price of that fruit hammock?
I'm going to go $25.
$25, she says. What is the price? That's right. And not only that, audience, not only that, when we play this game, if you get one of them exactly right, you automatically win all three. So she wins the fruit hammock, the cooker, the candle holder, and she gets three more cars. What number do you want? What number do you want?
Okay, I would like 11.
You want 11? You get that. Now, another card. What do you want?
26.
She wants 27. There you are. And one more.
Seven.
There we are. Now, Amy, do you want to just take the easy way out of this? You can have $2,500 and forget that car.
No.
You want to go on? Let's look at the first card we have, a C. You want to take $2,000 and quit? No, she wants to go on. Car! She has a car. She has an A. She has an R. Look at that. Unbelievable. The greatest spelling bee player of all time. That's not it, but that's all right. Now go. You have four chances left. 9,000. 20. Go ahead now. Write the price down. 9,000 what? Hurry up now, you lose your dad. She barely got it up there as the buzzer sounded, and it's not right anyway. But now you're going to lose your turn, see? When I say go, you have 10 seconds. And if you don't get it down there, they're going to give you the buzzer. Now you have three chances left. The price of that watch?
$395.
No.
Or you changed your mind?
All right.
$2,500. Can I change it again?
All right. Now, just a moment, audience. Clint wants to change his price. What do you say, Clint?
$350.
$350. Clint says $350. Is he right? All right. The mountain climber is going to move one step for every dollar you miss the prize. That's right, Diane. I'm going to sit down, too. Just going to take some money. Sit down here, Clint. Just sit here with me and relax, because we'll know when it happens. We'll hear it. It's going to take a little time, but he's still singing, so he's still all right. The audience singing along now. There he goes. Now you said $350. The price of the watch was what? $25. You missed it. $325.
Too bad.
Yes, Clint. And we found it. We found the three. Let's go all the way to the end of the Golden Road to the Corvette, which is more than $61,000. $61,000, then 2 and 5. Now, is that third digit 2, 3, 6, or 9 from that price tag? What do you say?
Bob, I'm going for the 9.
She's going for the 9, ladies and gentlemen. She's going for the 9. $61,925 is what we want. Where do you live?
Where do you think I live, Bob?
I have no... Oh, Alaska. You live in Alaska.
Yes.
And wouldn't you be whipping around in that in Alaska?
Yes, I would.
Oh, you would love it.
We could go for a snowy ride.
You could go for a snowy ride. How long have you lived up there?
I was born in and raised
there. Oh, you've lived there your whole life. $61,925 is right. It is right. He has won the Corvette. Congratulations. You are going to be whipping around Algeria, you wish. You'll be whipping around Alaska in your Corvette.
I really enjoy your show. Thank you so much.
I bet you enjoy it today.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Start pushing. Start pushing. They have to get four numbers up there. Now, won't it move? Well, let me see. This is an historic moment on The Price is Right. Can you believe it? This thing, now let's not stop tape. Let's get this worked out because people at home are going to be interested. Why won't that thing go through there? Now, let's see. Now, I'll push the first four. Well, it stops, right? I give up. What's wrong with it? I don't understand why that won't go through there. Now, look under every one of these things. Do you see anything? Well, why won't that do that? Now, you got the view. If that's right, fine. If not, then I'll put.
A new Porsche! The Porsche 968 Coupe. Sleek, classy sports car. Fits the lifestyle of the 90s. Equipped with all the standard features plus these options. Partial leather seating, radio with compact disc player, floor mats, cellular phone, auto alarm, low jack tracking system, paint sealant, fabric sealant, and California emission.
Tony, come back here. Come back here, Tony. Right over here. You know, I thought I was going to have to play this game by myself.
And you don't get to spin it again. Here we go. $5,000 if it stops on one of the green sections. $10,000 if it stops on the dollar. Now there it goes. And this is the one that will make the big difference. It is on a dollar.
Tony, you bid $18,000 on your showcase. And, Tony, the actual retail price of your showcase is $21,806, a difference of $3,806. That's a pretty good bid. Bradley, you bid $9,000 on your showcase. And, Bradley, the actual retail price of your showcase is $15,244, a difference of $6,244. You win. You have won $79,845 in prizes.
In the first half of The Price is Right, let's see if you can win some money now. Get a dollar, we'll give you $1,000. $1,000 for a dollar. You got it. $1,000, and you get a
bonus spin. Right over there you go. Come on, Lindsay, spin that wheel. Here we go with our second spinner. You can't beat Sherelle, but you can tie her. $1 is what you have to have if you're going to stick around. You have 70 cents. One more spin. Get yourself 30 cents this time. Looking for 30 cents. Looking for 30 cents. There it went. Here it comes. Here it comes. What a blow. She walked off sobbing as she walked off the stage. Suzanne spin. Suzanne, we have found out, did indeed have this shirt made on her 21st birthday. Now she's 32. 50 cents. Actually, you were 21 4 days ago, right? 50 cents. You need 50 cents one more time. Did she do it again? Yes! Another $1. Right here you are. Come back here, Sherelle. Now, this is going to be a bonus spin and a spin-off. We will determine which one of you will be in the showcase, and be sure you get it all the way around or it doesn't count and you don't get to spin again. Here we go, folks. It's a spin-off and a bonus spin. Now, what have we here? What have we here? $10,000. You've won $10,000 more. You've won a total of $11,000, and you have $1 for the spin-off. Now, I tell you, here we are. Come over here, Suzanne. There you go. One spin. Be sure you get it all the way around. Boy, I tell you, that Sherelle is hot. Everything she touches. Now, this could be close, too. This could be close. This could be close. You got it! That's the first time in history that has ever happened. That is the first time in history. Now, never before in the history of The Price is Right has this happened. This is the first time. You have won $11,000. You have won $11,000. And now, from right here, we'll go right on with the spinoff. Go ahead. It's just a spinoff now. Go ahead. There you go. It is just a spin-off now to determine which one of them will be in the showcase. And she has a nickel. Back you go. All right, it's a spin-off. You have to beat a nickel to get into the showcase. You have to beat a nickel to get in the showcase with just one spin. And you did it. You are going to be in our showcase, Suzanne.
You got them all. Now, you step right over here. Kathleen will give you four more Plinko chips to go with that one. Climb those steps. Take your place at the top of the board. And if you'll look down here in these slots, you'll see the same numbers we see out here. 5,000, 0, 1,000, 500, 100. Hold one Plinko chip flat against the board and release it any place you wish. Here comes her first Plinko chip, and it is going to be worth zero. Nothing for that one. All right, try again, Margie. Try again, Margie. Here we go into zero. Margie, now you understand the game. You get what it goes in, and zero is zero. Now let's put that thing in a slot where you win some money. Look at that. Look at that. Well, it's going into... I can't believe this. This is terrible. Now try again, Margie. No matter where she starts it, it goes to the zero. I can't believe this. Now wait just a moment. A bit of prices right here. That ties a record. Four zeros is the record for Plinko. If this next one goes in, you are the all-time Plinko loser, I'm afraid. That's not a record you want. You want money. And she started it clear over here. Five zeros in a row. Margie, Plinko is probably the most popular game on our show.
It was.
Thank you, Margie. That's exactly what I thought you would say.
We're going to give you a chance to make your move. This goes under the two numbers in the price of the vacuum. This goes under the three numbers in the price of the carousel horse. This goes under the four numbers in the price of the piano. All right, Shirley, make your move. Use each number, but use it only once. Don't overlap. She thinks that vacuum is 30. Two numbers. Yep. Come on, Shirley, make your move. Two numbers. Help this woman. Help Shirley. Put it under the two numbers, Shirley. All right, is that where you want it? 95? All right, now put that under the three numbers and the price of the horse. Now wait, Shirley, you can't do that. See, you'd have these numbers left, and there's no place to do. You think that's right? You think the horse is 339? I can't get Shirley to move. You can put that down there. Yeah, is that what you want to do? Three for that. All right. Well, decide one that you think you know the price and put it there. You see, you can't have the numbers like this. You can't have them overlap. So you'd have to do that and that. You see what I mean? Or you put this someplace else, put it there, there, wherever you want. Could we do a commercial during this? That's right. You have to use all the numbers, but you can put that any place you want, but you have to keep in mind that, see? Okay. I don't know how to handle this situation. Shirley? Now. All right. Do you have an idea what the price of this is?
The vacuum cleaner, probably $99.
All right, we'll put that there. Now, do you think the horse is $725?
Yeah.
All right, we'll put that there. Now, you think the piano is $3,295? Now, just a moment. Just a moment. If that's right, I win.
She has $95 for the vacuum, $725 for the horse, $3,395 for the piano. Is that right? I win! I win! I win! I win! I've won the game. They are my prizes. Nope, no, you stay back there. I'm the winner. There's more prizes right coming up.
You don't want to do it? They love you. They... You don't want to do it? No. During the last commercial, I asked Lori, your dear friend, I said, would it be cute to have her do that? And she said they'd love to see you do the gator.
Maybe Lori'd like to do it with me.
Well, can you do it with her? Is there anyone on our show who does the gator beside you?
Andy?
And, well, I'm not going to ask her to do it then by herself. If Andy will do it with her, why, on The Price is Right, we will... Here comes Andy. Andy will do it. All right, hurry up, Andy. Where is he? Where is Andy? There's the music. Come on, Andy, where is he? Get him out here. We can't take forever here. Come on, Andy. Right out here. Here they are. Andy Jacobson and Finger Speckle. Go, go, go. I have never been so disappointed in my life.
Arkless Family Gym provides easy exercising in the privacy of your home for family members of all ages. No installation required from Arkla. And to the winner of this exercise equipment goes an assortment of no-nonsense pantyhose, a complete range of styles for your every need, no-nonsense fit, comfort, and terrific-looking legs at a no-nonsense price.
On behalf of the manufacturer of that product, I would like to point out that is not the way it usually works.
Well, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Hello, Ethel.
Hi. I had a dream about you.
Just speak into the microphone. I couldn't hear you.
I said I had a dream about you, I had to come down here.
What were we doing in the dream?
You were chasing me in the hayloft.
Well, as a matter of fact, I can remember in South Dakota doing a little chasing in a hayloft or two.
Yeah, me too.
Can you?
Step over there and write that check with our blessing. He's checking to see if there are any Canadians in the audience. There's several, apparently. Trying to make up his mind. Go ahead, Jeffrey. He's a lefty. I've been getting left-handers in this game lately. That's right. I wonder, do you suppose the number of left-handed people in the United States is increasing? Have you noticed I've had a lot of left-handers in this game lately? Fingers, you're left-handed, aren't you? You write left-handed. Fingers writes left-handed. All right. $4,900. Is that the amount? All right. $4,900. $4,900. I'm worried, aren't you?
Yeah!
Any Canadians out there?
Yeah!
Costs more than that to get to Canada, doesn't it?
Yeah!
Great, it does. What is the amount of that trip? $3,267, a total of $8,167. Void that check. I am sorry. But I will say this. I believe that's about as much as anyone has ever ended up with as a total in check game. So you can take some satisfaction in that.
The actual retail price is $1,099. Robert wins his way out of contestant throw after having been down there since the beginning of our show.
Robert, you've done it.
22 years to shake your hand.
Well, it's a pleasure.
I have this.
What
do you have? This is for Janice. I wrote my senior thesis on game show hostesses, and here's an article. Oh, my God. Hi, everybody. Oh, my God.
Now, he wrote his senior thesis
on game show hostesses.
And you wrote it about Janice?
Yes, most
well,
of
that's wonderful.
It's about Janice.
And well, how come they have a picture of me here?
That's an article that I wrote for a newspaper.
Well, thank you. Here she is. She wants the thesis.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You just made my dream.
I can die now. I don't need to win anything. I can die.
He's a fine young man. He says, I can die now. I don't need to win anything. He's met Janet.
And you.
And me.
And Rod.
Well, I know who came first, though. Who'd you write about? Janet, not me.
Now, you are $487 away from $21. You win if you spend just $387. You want to get between $20 and $21.
But it's ice cream.
No, that's not ice cream. That's utter cream. That's a skin softener, isn't it? George is going to eat that. We can't. No, don't do that. What do you say, George? One of these, one utter cream. That is $449. What's his total? Oh, George. He's over. No, wait. He's over $21.
It's a win.
Now, wait. Is that... Did he go over? I tell you what, I'm going to make an executive decision. You put up win, he wins. Roll that next number. Is it 6? Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but never before in this game has the contestant rolled those three numbers in a row. Never. So you've already made history on The Price is Right. But if you can roll that last number, it will be absolutely perfect. No one will ever do better. Roll. Here we go. Is that last number a 4? No. Now, do you believe that the last number in the price is higher or lower than 4?
It's lower, Bob.
It's lower. He's gone with the odds. 1, 2, or 3, and he wins. A 5 or a 6 would beat him. Here, we gave him this number. He rolled all of these. Fate could never be so cruel as to have him lose this car, could it? No, it couldn't. Light up that number. William, bring out a gurney and take him to sick bay. He's not going to be able to take this. Now, Leola, you have won that prize. We hope you win this one.
Appliances for your kitchen. From Gibson, kitchen appliances featuring a frost-free refrigerator freezer with adjustable cantilever shelves, removable door racks and a total energy-saving system, a portable dishwasher, 3 levels of washing action, and energy saver switch, a microwave oven with digital timer and 10% cooking probe, and a module master electric range self-cleaning oven, all from Gibson, one of the white consolidated industry. And you'll also receive a supply of Electrosol. It removes stuff from stores, your dishwashers, lighters, on counter. Everything comes out shining, clean, and sparkling with Electrosol. It's a prize package with $2,445.
Oh. I tell you, the things that happened to that Holly, unbelievable. You know, you couldn't write that kind of stuff, could you? But with Holly, it just happens naturally.
Yes, it is. $8,000 is serious money. That's serious money. That is serious money. $8,000. Do you want to risk losing that and go on and try for 16? $8,000.
Oh, my God. I'll go.
She's going on. Now, if this is spray, is it not cooking spray? If that is in that bag, you will, are you listening to me?
Yes.
This is important stuff I'm saying.
I'm so scared.
If that is in this bag, you will win $16,000.
Oh, my God.
But if it's not, you're going to lose $8,000. Is it in that bag? $16,000. Showcase showdown number one after this.
Howdy, Scott.
Hey.
Now, Scott, I think this would fit you perfectly.
A new station wagon.
Are you all right? He's hurt his leg. Oh, thank you. Are you all right?
Yeah.
You sure?
I think so.
Well, all right. Step over here, Scott. Now, did you turn your ankle or your knee? You hurt your knee?
I'm okay.
Now, you want a chair?
No, I'm okay.
All right. If you're all right, well, yes. 15,000. Now, don't jump. Don't jump. Don't jump. You only have one good leg left there. Is that third number higher than four? Oh! Oh, there he goes. Oh, his knee went out here. We'll have our showcase showdown after we get Scott out. Oh.
And now here's Bob Barker with our showcase showdown.
Now, I want you to promise me one thing. I'm going to... He's asked me to spin the wheel for him, and I'm going to spin the wheel for him. If I get a dollar, don't jump up. Stay right there and be happy. All right, here we go, Scott. Whoa! And... Scott, you have 85 cents. You'll stay. He's going to stay. I'm glad. I think I hurt my arm, then I spun. Get up. Let me sit down there for a minute. No, I was kidding. Come on, Lee. You spin the wheel. Now, should we take Scott around there? Here, you go ahead. No, stay in the chair. Roll him around there, Roger. Take him over. I know one. There, oh, Scott. He's a bundle of energy. Oh, Scott. I tell you, you are going to be one of the most memorable contestants we have ever had on this show. And the first bidder is Grandma Helen.
$1,200.
$1,200. Jamie?
$950.
Her bid is $950. Christy?
$999.
$999. Norman?
$1,201.
$1,201. Now, that Grandma? You know, many times when contestants use that strategy, why a contestant next to them will kind of, you know, this or hit him. I've never had a contestant walk the full length of contestant's row. And she waited till his head was turned and then slugged him in the back. On the front of her shirt, it says, I'm a go-go grandma. On the back, it should say, and I'm sneaky. But that was the signal that one of you is exactly right, you understand? One of you has won $100. And it's the contestant who bid $1,200. It's Helen. Helen, come up here. Now, where do you live?
Fresno, California!
Fresno, California. And we all know that Fresno is known
as a place where there is a lot of snow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So you'd like to have that.
An hour and a half away.
Just an hour and a half to the snow.
Yeah.
Now, do you know how... What brought all that on? Are you with the group?
I'm with the group.
What is the group?
I'm with the bus group.
Oh, it's just a bunch of people, not a club or something.
Oh. Yeah.
I can tell by the looks on their faces they don't know what their group is up there. Now, this is a very complicated game. Have you ever seen it on our show?
Oh, I don't think so. I think
well,
I'm gonna...
You begin here. You push. You see, the game is called Pushover. You put what?
Snowmobile.
But what do you think we're talking about here? Why do you think I'm talking about the snow in Fresno?
Oh, yeah. There's snow in Wawona.
I believe it's normal. She's all right. Now, and the actual retail price is $2,200. You win, Linda. Linda. We would like to have you come right up here and stop. Now.
I'm ready.
You are ready indeed. When you put your arm around me, I discovered that you are surprisingly strong. That, yes. Now, I want to show you a prize. But before I show you the prize, I want you to promise me that you will not do me bodily harm. Okay?
Okay.
Now, I think I will step right back here, about this far. Maybe a little farther, about this far. And then I will say, gentlemen, will you please bring it in?
It's a new car!
Actual retail price, $13.55. Garnett. Here comes Garnett. Screaming with delight. Screaming with delight. Yeah. You're up here, Garnett.
Garnett.
I beg your pardon?
Garnett.
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 Garnett. Darn it, Garnett. I'm sorry I called you Garnett. Now, Garnet, she's not through screaming. I'll wait. Now, listen, just a moment, Garnet. You're becoming hysterical. Now, just settle down here. Just settle down.
Thank you.
Yes, everything will be all right. I got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm better.
All right. Sherry, you have bid $18,888 on your showcase, and the actual retail price is $21,027. Pretty good. A difference of $2,139. Garnet, you bid $27,135 on your showcase. Garnet, the actual retail price of your showcase is $27,331. You win both showcases with a difference of only $196. Terrific! You have won both showcases, Barney. Yes! Yeah. 57,000.
I told my mother and
my
15 brothers and sisters that if I saw you, I'd wave to them if I gave you just a kiss on the hand. I did.
You want to give me a kiss on
the
hand?
Yes, all my 15 brothers and sisters are watching. They will be, I promise. Just a kiss. Oh, Bob.
Now, what is the next item up for bid?
Okay, the dog food.
The dog food, $369 here. What is the price?
$3.79, she saved a dime. I'll tell you what she saved. I think it's stuck. Well, I can subtract 69 to 79. So now she has 80 cents in the bank. There, now they tell me. Oh, it's plus 10. Now, wait a minute. 80 cents in the bank, right. Clarista, you are going to have a chance to make your move. Do you know how to play this game?
Yeah, I think.
How do you think you play it?
Whichever item first, you decide on whichever number that you want. I'm nervous. I don't know.
Clarista, I believe that a person would have a pretty difficult time playing the game, following your directions. What are you going to do with this?
I'm going to decide on the price of the spice rack.
That's right. What are you going to do with this?
Same thing.
Well, the same thing?
Decide on the price.
Of the what?
Of the hostess. Thing.
And what are you going to do with that?
And then the jukebox.
Do it. Make your move, Clarista. Use each number only once. Do not overlap the numbers.
Don't overlap.
That's right. Clarista, now look what you've done. You've done everything I told you not to do. You overlapped this and you didn't use the five. Now get with it, Clarista. That's... Are you, is that it? Now, where do you have that? Is that under 55? Is that where you want? All right. Now, listen, Clarista. I don't blame you for stopping because you're on the verge of a nervous breakdown here. You know that? The louder you were screaming, you couldn't see her face. She was beginning. I thought I was going to have to call a halt here and let you settle your nerves. Then you believe that the spice rack is $55. You believe that the hostess set is $195, and according to you, the jukebox is $5,884. What?
Can I ask a question?
You can ask a question, but it's too late to change.
Okay, fine.
Is that your question?
Yes.
You and I are getting along very well, because I can read your mind, see? I knew you were cracking up. Now... The question I want to ask is Clarista right? No. What are the right prices, please? Well, Clarista, that was $45. This is $5,000, but it's $5,195. And this is $5,88. Oh, but now wait. What we must remember is that you'll be back to spin the big wheel. You may win $11,000 and straighten out your whole life. And we will bring out yet and... Oh, I hope you're musical. Are you?
No.
You're not.
No.
You're not a drummer.
No.
But you could become one.
I could.
Well,
yes.
Step over here. But now just step over here. Step right behind there. And just try it. Just try it. Now let her try. Let us... Oh, that's good. That's good. That is good. Those are for you, and Rod will tell you about those.
$36. Now, let me point out, before we go any further, that in the word car, there are three letters. So far, you have only two letters. Now, you are in desperate need of one more letter. What is the price of the salad maker?
I'm going $25, Bob.
$25. What is the price? $46. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are in an interesting situation here. She has only two cards, so she can only have two letters. But on this board, there are two cards on which it says car. If she should get one of those, she would win the car anyway. However, it is my job and my responsibility to point out to you that the odds are certainly against you. However, you may quit, take the $1,000, or you can look at the cards and hope it says car on one of them.
Take the car! Take the car! Take the car!
Oh, my friends are telling me go for it, of course. They're not sitting on $1,000.
Well, yes, but now let me point out something else. She says her friends are saying go for it. I should like to point out your friends don't have $1,000 to lose either.
You know what? I've already won, so, and that's my anniversary date, so I'm just going to go for it.
You're going for it. Now, this would be one of our greatest wins all time if she has a card that says car. No, it says A. Now, this has to be car. I hope.
It is the car. It says car. Who wins the car? Wins the car. Terrific.
A new jukebox. The Wurlitzer Estrella jukebox with 200 selections, stereo amplifier, Shure magnetic pickup, electronic coin counter, and automatic top tunes. It's a prize worth $2,953.
Listen, I have never seen that girl go like that before. What is going on here today? She has that one uncontrollable hip. Did you notice that? Poor baby. I'm going to have to talk with her after the show. Do you know what Janice said as she handed me this microphone today? She said, Barker, be careful of that contestant on the end. And I don't think she meant you, Geneva.
No.
Leslie, did you do something in the way that you came on down to indicate that...
You wouldn't believe it.
I wouldn't?
No,
I wouldn't believe what?
They told us exactly. Oh, to walk so nicely, and I turned the wrong way. And he told
us. What happened? Where were you?
Oh, I don't remember.
You don't?
Here.
You were in there. Well, that's tough to get out of. That's the start.
Yeah.
Then what did you do? How did you get out of there?
I don't know, but you saw the wrong half of me.
We saw.
You know what?
Well, I've got bad news for you. You've turned the wrong hat. That's better.
That's
now.
Right.
Oh, gosh, you're never going to believe this.
No, Leslie, just calm yourself because
really good looking.
I beg your pardon.
Okay. I didn't mean it like. Aren't I weird? Oh, I'm so excited. This is unbelievable. I feel like. Oh, gosh.
Now, Leslie.
Yes.
Everything is going to be all right.
I know.
You do know? Then believe me, you know better than I, if you know that.
I know one thing. I can't jump on you.
You. Well, now, Leslie. I would not have gone so far as to have said that myself. We may work out something in the parking lot after the show. But right now, let's have a look at the first item up for bids.
Before we go on here, just a moment. They have a shot of Rod over here, do we not? Yes, we do.
Hi.
Now, Wayne, could you get this young lady here? Would you stand up, Lori? Look at this. Look at those jackets. Now, Rod has always told me that he has his jackets made in Thailand, and he spends a fortune on them. I asked Lori where she got hers. She said you got it a sale across the street here. So I kind of wonder about Rod now. Who's our next player, Rod?
Bob, would you believe? Would you believe it's Lori Woolweaver? Come on up. That's what on the price is right.
No. No, I don't believe it. As so many contestants have said on The Price is Right, I don't believe it. Oh, that's wonderful. Richard, it is a pleasure to have you with us. You are a Lakers fan. You look more like you might be a Lakers player, you know? He really does. Doesn't he look? He's in great shape, and he's, yeah. What are we going to bid on, please, gentlemen?
A mobile basketball system. Harvard's serious play mobile basketball system. Now basketball can be portable even for the serious player. A serious play mobile system from Harvard, and we have added a basketball.
Wait, don't close the doors for just a moment. Did you play basketball?
Yes, sir.
Can you dunk?
Yes, I can.
Get up there and show us a dunk. Get up. Here he goes. He's going to show us a dunk. He's going to dunk for us. Let Richard have that ball. Here he is. Richard dunking on The Price is Right. There he goes. Now, back down to contestants row.